dry mouth happens when you don't produce enough saliva. This can be as a result of medication and can be made worse by day-to-day food and lifestyle choices, like alcohol, smoking, and even some foods. Saliva is important to maintain a healthy mouth. It keeps your mouth moist, which helps with things like taste and chewing, even talking. Saliva also helps keep your mouth clean by washing your teeth and providing minerals for repair. It also helps prevent infections and reduces the risk of tooth decay and gum disease. But there are many ways to improve the symptoms of dry mouth.
Hey, Deb.
Hi, how are you?
Good. I just thought I should check. You mentioned at breakfast you're having a little bit of trouble eating. Can you tell me what's happening?
My mouth is so dry and sore. It hurts when I swallow when I'm eating. It's actually, it hurts when I'm trying to talk. If I eat toast, I feel like I've just cut the inside of my mouth, and then ulcers appear and they just won't go away.
Okay. Well, what you're describing is dry mouth, and it basically means reduced or no saliva. It's pretty common, actually. It's caused by medications and some illnesses, and things like smoking, alcohol, some foods and mouthwashes even can make it worse.
Oh, okay. Well, I've actually started to cut back on my smoking. Is there anything else you suggest?
Well, basically, you need to keep your mouth moist. This will help make things more comfortable when you're eating and talking. If you can carry some tap water around with you and sip it throughout the day, this will help keep things more comfortable.
I don't really like water a lot, so could I maybe sip on like cordial or orange juice?
Tap water is actually best. Things like cordials and juices and other drinks like that can contain a lot of sugar, which isn't great for our teeth. But tap water has fluoride, which actually makes your teeth stronger.
Oh, okay, well, I guess that makes sense then.
You need to increase the amount of saliva in your mouth, and this can be done a few different ways, like chewing sugar-free gum.
But I always thought that chewing gum was bad for your teeth.
No, not if it's sugar-free, it's fine. It actually increases the amount of saliva in your mouth, and this makes things more comfortable.
So would that help with cracked lips?
Maybe a little, but I suggest using a lip balm. Something like an SPF lip balm is even better because it helps protect against the sun.
I've heard of this thing called fake saliva. Does that work?
Yeah, well, there are a lot of products available at the pharmacy and they work really well and they're inexpensive. Things like toothpaste, mouthwashes and antibacterial gels. If you ask your pharmacy team, they'll be able to give you a lot of good advice.
Okay, well, I do go to my pharmacist regularly to get my medication, so that should be no problem trying to find someone to help me there.
Yeah. Now, you mentioned before about smoking. Have you actually quit or are you still giving up?
Yeah, I've tried to quit so many times, but I will say that this time's been a lot more successful because I've actually halved the amount that I used to smoke, so.
It is really hard, but cutting down to half, you're doing really well. Look, don't forget to ask for help if you need it. Things like your pharmacist will have some advice, your local GP, or even the quit line, they deal with this every day.
So do you think I need to see my dentist?
If you haven't had an appointment for a while, it's probably a good idea, especially as you do have dry mouth, and it does put you at a higher risk of tooth decay.
Okay, well, I'd probably best make an appointment then.
It's up to you. But if you want, you can go online and find out what services are available, whether that you want to go public or private, and what's around.
That's awesome. Thank you so much for your help.
You're welcome. Hey, I'll see you at lunch.
Okay.
Okay,
see
cool.
Ya.
I've always felt self-conscious about my teeth, and I worried about bad breath and that people were staring at me. My mouth always felt uncomfortable, which I now know was because of some of the medications I was taking. I even thought people could sense my lack of confidence, which is not a good feeling. The dryness of my mouth had made it hard to eat, and I sometimes felt I was choking when I was swallowing, and I was always biting the inside of my cheek, and food tasted weird. Sometimes I couldn't even taste it at all. I thought I was going to have to live with dry mouth forever, and I thought that any options for relief would be really expensive. I want to make sure I do whatever it takes to reduce the risk of tooth decay and gum disease. I really just want to feel better.